standing on stage can be a terrifying experience, and I don't think that you can be an actor without feeling at least a twinge of nerves before the curtain goes up. Then again, Rory Booth seemed completely confident when he performed a brilliant one-man production locally and later at a London theatre festival recently. Titled Reoca Light, it told the story of an Indian family who put everything on the line to survive and realize a dream in South Africa. We met up with Rory, playwright Ashwin Singh, and director Rolf Lawson before their departure for the UK.
The Hindu scriptures say that this is a bad time. Yeah, even the shop is not as popular as before. And you know, Sunil.
Award-winning playwright and director Ashwin Singh is world-renowned for captivating his audiences with his authentic storytelling. His latest production, Reoca Light, will be treading the boards of London. But before the team jets off, they've invited us along for their final rehearsal.
Only walk the dog on Saturday mornings. Don't do the dishes. Your method is all wrong. Hey! I'd rather run away, yeah, and smoke my cigar in peace. You know, I never should have signed the house over to them when my wife passed away.
Hi, Ashwin.
Hi, Michelle. Good to meet you.
Thank you so much for having us here.
Oh, wonderful. Great that you've come and given us this opportunity. You see, Rory is busy rehearsing at the moment.
Johnny Naidu. I'd forgotten how many photos I had of him. Yeah, Uncle Johnny. The man of many guises.
He's doing a number of different characters and there's quite a bit of physical theatre as well. So ideally suited to it because he's got such a variety of skills.
There was one side of Uncle Johnny that nobody knew about. A side that I was to discover in the first years of the new millennium. Uncle Johnny, the romantic. Now, romantic gestures were not exactly put on public display in Little Reoca. I mean, we were an Indian town. And a few years after his wife had passed away, I noticed Uncle Johnny displaying a little extra charm whenever the widow, Auntie Mina, visited the butcher shop.
Thanks for the support, Mina. You know, the other day I got some nice sardines at a good price. I was going to make it this weekend and my son and daughter-in-law said they're going away. Plus my friend Bobby said he can't make it, he got a family function. It's a pretty.
Ashwin, you're jetting off to the UK shortly. How are you feeling?
I'm excited. This is the first theatre production I'm doing there. And London is still one of the leading arts centres of the world. And of course, Roy is a great talent and so is Ralph. So I'm privileged to go with them.
What do you most hope that the audience takes away from the show?
Well, I wanted to see the diverse nation that we are, where every particular culture has an important role to play. We're looking at the harsh reality of our world, but also the beauty, the complexity, the diversity. So it is a celebration of who we are, but also a critical analysis because one has to have a balance and present an honest picture.
Absolutely. I see they're taking a break. I'd love to meet the cast and director.
Come through. This is Michelle.
Rory, pleased to meet you.
How are you doing?
As a one-man play, what are some of the challenges that you face?
I think most importantly is stamina and focus. You cannot allow yourself to be distracted, else it's so easy to lose your train of thought. The main challenge is playing 15 characters, but I think hard work, determination, but mainly focus gets you through it.
Now this is very much a South African Indian story. How do you think it will travel, especially you going off to UK to perform it?
Reoca Light is a story that just shows anyone around the world, whether you're Indian, black, white, colored, Asian, that our stories are the same. We face the same challenges wherever you are.
And now you can meet our director, Rolf Lawson. He's directed this piece in Durban and also directed two of my other plays, Into the Grey and To House, a renowned national director. He's also lived and worked in the UK and directs regularly for the Playhouse.
Rolf.
How do you do?
Welcome to Mela.
Thank you.
Why do you believe it's important to share our South African stories on an international stage?
As a country of artists, we haven't really had much exposure overseas. I don't know that people know much about what we do in the theatre here, for instance, or in the arts in general. So I hope we're going to put that right and show them.
Well, I know time is money and you've got to get back to rehearsal before you jet off to UK. Thank you so much and good luck.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Ashwin, it would be great to chat to you a bit more.
Absolutely. Let's take a walk this way.
No, Uncle Johnny, it was just an innocent kiss, man. No, I just wanted a place to talk and so that I could read Jayshree my poem. Yeah, you know,
our parents don't want us to be together. No, not because I'm colored and she's Indian. It's because I'm Christian and she's Hindu. Her father said that if I don't stay away from his daughter, he'll chop off my limbs and screw my legs to my shoulders. I mean, look at me, Uncle Johnny. Does it look like I can walk on my hands?
Ashwin, the play combines comedy, drama, and physical theater to explore the characteristics of a South African Indian family. How do you balance comedy with drama?
Well, I don't make such a big distinction between comedy and drama. Great comedies have moments of drama and pathos. And I think that if you're going to do a really substantial comedy, there would be elements of drama in it. Life is like that as well. Tragedy can be followed by some humorous moments. And of course, in humor, sometimes we find sadness. So I'm going to be true to our lives in depicting comedy and drama together.
Ashwin, as a playwright, what does it mean to you to have your work taught at universities and schools?
That's probably the highest reward I've received, just because if we're going to have these works be told for different generations, then they have to be in a book and they have to be taught at universities and schools. And so for me, that would mean there's some kind of legacy that I may be leaving, which is irrelevant for me, the name Ashwin Singh, but just in terms of those stories living on and different people interpreting it differently over the years.
I know your immediate plans is to jet off to UK and showcase this amazing play, but after that, what's next?
I'm actually making a transition now from being purely in theatre into film, particularly documentary film, but also fiction. So that's one of the main areas I'm going to focus on when I get back. But obviously, there's still theatre, and we'll be doing some work here, particularly a conference next year with a number of those international academics who've written on my work. They'll be presenting here in Durban, and we'll probably restage Reoca Light at the end of that conference for some of the people who haven't seen it yet.
Ashwin, thank you so much for the work that you do.
Thank you so much for the opportunity.
How can we let it become so filthy, so uncared for? Our grandparents must be rolling in their graves.
Nobody liked him when he ran for local councillor. He only got 6 votes.
This is our home. Let's make it beautiful again.
Combining comedy, drama, and bold visuals, Reoca Light is most certainly a unique theatrical experience.
The trio jetted off to London, where the production was presented as part of the Tara Arts International season. The one-man play had a 6-night run at the theatre, which is home to a company renowned for bringing high-quality artists from across the globe to the UK stage. Rory's performance held the audience in rapt attention.
I know the people love my father, but they see him as the kind-hearted uncle who stands behind the shop counter, the one who listens to their life stories while selling them groceries and goodies, the man who helped create the light of Reoca.